If you want to shoot the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn from a city, you're going to have to get high because there's buildings all around in a city, and the great conjunction is only 20 degrees above the horizon, which is about from pinky to thumb extended. And so maybe you can see it right over here. You need what's called a horizon, a clear horizon. So the only way to get that in a city is usually to get high. So what I did is I found this parking ramp, and I'm paying for parking right now, but I don't mind because this is so cool. And I went all the way to the top of the parking ramp and have set up my camera up here. And I have this great clear view of the conjunction right over the Charles River here in Boston. And so this is my main tip. If you're photographing the Great Conjunction, do some planning. We're still 6 days out right now from the closest pass of the two planets, which is December 21st, also called the Great Conjunction or the Christmas Star. And so I hope that I get clear skies that night, but because I've done this scouting and I've picked out this spot, I know that it's going to be a great spot if we do get a clear sky. And I'm going to bring all my gear up here, all my different camera lenses and telescopes and binoculars, so that I can really get a cool experience viewing it and photographing it. I don't have too many tips for exactly how to photograph it, because everyone's gear is different. What I recommend is just whatever gear you have, bring it with you and try to get some photos of this, because it's so cool. The closer that the planets get together, of course, the longer your lens will have to be to resolve that separation. So on the actual 21st, you would probably need like a fairly long lens to actually see that they're not just one object. They're going to get that close together. And another thing I would really recommend is if you have any kind of pair of binoculars, bring them, because this is going to be a great thing to view through binoculars. Okay, well, I hope this has provided a few useful tips for viewing and photographing the Great Conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn from a city. Again, to review, find a high spot. So this could be a hill, a parking ramp like we are here, the top of a building, anything like that, and that's going to give you your best shot at actually seeing it. And two, actually, I haven't said this yet. Don't wait for the 21st, because you don't know what the weather's gonna be like on the 21st. So as soon as you have an opportunity, a clear night like tonight, to go look at this, go look at it. To find it, you're just gonna look approximately southwest, get there right at sunset, and it will get clearer and clearer as the sun goes down. It's now approaching night, and it's really, really clear. And Jupiter and Saturn are just like this far apart if I hold out my hand like that. They're really close together. This has been a little bit scattered, but I hope you got something out of this. I'm gonna go ahead and continue my testing with all my different cameras and lenses, because I want to get the most out of this before it sets for tonight. All right, till next time, this has been Nico Carver, nebulaphotos.com.